My name is Monika Kalinowska, and I'm working at the Institute of Geophysics, Polish Academy of Sciences, in Hydrology and Hydrodynamic Department. And I had the pleasure to take a part in the Britec project as a scientist responsible for one of the pilot actions involving young people in observation of river and riparian vegetation, and also changes that may occur during the whole year. Some of the school, depending actually on the pupil's age, their possibilities and equipment, were also observing some simple meteorological and hydrological conditions, like for example water level or water temperature or air temperature. The vegetation monitoring were conducted by taking photographs using simple cameras, like for example those available in our mobile phones, in some intervals at least once per month. Then the results of photo monitoring, the photos together with some measurements, if any, were sent to me using specially prepared and discussed during the school visits online forms. We would like to use the information gathered by pupils in our ongoing studies related to how vegetation affects the water flow and also mixing processes in water. These mixing processes could be related to different kind of dissolved substance in the water that could be, for example, pollutants. Also, this kind round year observation of various rivers and water courses in different locations in Poland will help us to choose the best location and time for our further so-called tracer experiments. Such experiments involve the releasing of the environmentally safe dye into the water and then observing how and how fast this dissolved substance is transported downstream. This finally allows us to determine the important parameters that describe the process of mixing of the dissolved substance, like for example pollutants.
I'm Joanna Ropka, teacher from Poland. I work in small Skonie Saliny, the village close to Krakow. I'm a big fan of alternative teaching methods and I'm trying to apply them to my work. I've got a PhD in physics, but I prefer working with children and teenagers. However, I still keep a scientist soul and it influences on my methods because I like to show my students how close they are to real science. Any project which applies citizen science in school is a perfect idea for all these teachers who want to combine a research approach with school skills. In my opinion, there are many benefits of citizen science applied for school practice. First of all, the biggest advantage is showing students that the science can be for them. Research requires plan and methods, which doesn't have to be too difficult for students. A success depends on hard work defined rather by work discipline than by high math. They could learn the research method in practice. They figured out how to collect data properly, how to present them. Students could make their own methods of measurements, for example, river depth or velocity field, what improved their creativity. Moreover, pupils could see the science doesn't have to be made in a big laboratory somewhere in the world, but also close to them, even in small village. It can raise students' self-esteem because they see that their small river can be important from scientific point of view for somebody. It improves their responsibility for our neighborhood. Finally, the citizen science approach is a fresh wind in school routine. Students can see school as a place where modern things can happen. The research applied in school shows students the way of looking for more than facts in school's books.